Right.
There's all these tracks that that I had recorded, but then I started getting like all this feedback slash pushback a little bit from the record label that just wasn't really sure. They weren't really sure what to do with it. They were excited that I was doing something else, but just were kind of in this, you know, strange place.
And I read too that from Bela too, you handed off these demos to him, and some of them there were things in there that he was into, but maybe to rework and sort of revisit.
Yeah, totally. So just to back up just a little bit, you know, talking about Alison Krauss, she's been like a wonderful, you know, friend and mentor of sorts for many years. And, you know, I was just it's going through this. I'm so fortunate. I mean, she's my biggest hero. So it's like still really wild to me that she's somebody I can call up and be like, I don't know what I'm doing right now. I need some advice, you know. But I just kind of found myself in a slightly... I hate to use the word dark, but kind of like a dark place about it all, where I just was like, you know, I'm excited about these songs that I've written, and I felt like for the first time that, you know, I had spent all this time in the bluegrass community, which I, you know, again, grateful for, loved, but people, you know, kind of knew me as this mandolin player, but like I had been writing a lot of songs over the, you know, the few years before Recording Weighted Mind, and really felt like it was time for me.